you're clambering through the bush on one of Indonesia's Lesser Sunda Islands when you suddenly spy a Komodo dragon in the clearing ahead. So, what should you do? Are you doomed? Forked tongue flickering, sharp, saw-like teeth glimmering, and strong, scaly body stretching up to 3 meters, Komodo dragons are formidable and the world's largest lizards. They can weigh over 80 kilograms, but that number fluctuates dramatically since they're capable of gulping down 80% of their body weight in a single meal. Komodo dragons are one of dozens of species of monitor lizard. They evolved in Australia and now inhabit just a few Indonesian islands where adult Komodos generally have no natural predators besides each other. They begin their lives as limber, tree-dwelling hatchlings. Within their first year, they rarely venture to the ground in order to avoid predators, like adult Komodo dragons. Because cannibalism certainly isn't out of the question, juveniles actively hunt insects and other lizards. And once they grow larger, they graduate to the ground, and their diet eventually shifts dramatically to include animals several times their size. They devour deer, pigs, and even water buffalo, bones and all. Komodos can lie in wait for hours alongside game trails, but at the opportune moment, they'll lunge and can reach 17 kilometer per hour bursts of speed. Their extremely sharp teeth have serrated edges and tips coated in iron that puncture and tear through flesh, making their bites quite literally metal. But exactly what Komodos owe their hunting successes to, especially when it comes to taking down larger animals like water buffalo, has been debated for decades. Back in the 80s, one researcher proposed that even if their prey initially escapes, Komodo dragon saliva might store harmful bacteria, which could proliferate in the bite wound and help kill the animal. But researchers have since found that not all Komodo dragon saliva packs such lethal bacteria, and some bite wounds might get infected all on their own. Interestingly, Komodo dragons also have venom glands, which secrete anticoagulant and shock-causing compounds, possibly exacerbating the destructive powers of their bites. But it's unclear whether venom is playing much of an active role. And Komodo's thrashing bites alone seem harmful enough to cause fatal injury much of the time. But they're not just hunters. Komodo dragons are also scavengers. With their characteristic undulating walk and their snake-like flicking forked tongue, they're able to gauge the direction of different scents and identify rotting flesh from afar. When one Komodo takes down a water buffalo, dozens may congregate to feed. However, despite regularly diving in to decaying corpses, Komodo dragons rarely succumb to infections themselves, even though males leave devastating wounds on each other during breeding season. Researchers think this is because their blood is packed with peptides, which are like small proteins, many of which can fight microbes and stimulate the Komodo's immune system. Some of these antimicrobial peptides have proven so promising, they're even being investigated for human antibiotic uses. But how can you protect yourself in the land of dragons? Komodo Island oral tradition holds that a woman long ago gave birth to twins, one human and one dragon. Inextricably connected from then on, the relationship between humans and Komodo dragons was to be governed by respect and coexistence instead of fear and violence. And indeed, Komodo dragons generally avoid humans, unless something like rotting flesh is also on the menu. If you encounter a Komodo, try to stay calm and avoid sudden movements that could pique their curiosity. You're better off orienting yourself behind them or to their side, If one gets close, you could grab a stick and push it against their shoulder or hit their sensitive foreheads. And in the rare event one chases you, try outrunning them, climbing a tree, or jumping into the ocean, because they can run fast over short distances, but they're no marathon runners, and large Komodos can't climb trees anymore and tend to avoid water. It's also worth noting that if you did end up in this situation, it's probably because you illegally ventured into a protected area without an experienced guide. So better to just avoid doing that to begin with. Ready to keep learning? Watch these videos to either challenge what you think you know or learn more about what you don't. Subscribe and stay curious.